Well, hello, goody people. It's nice to see you again. And obviously, I come to you today with Tokyo Ghoul Ray Chapter 3 review. I must say, I am enjoying this series. Like, I mean, I've always enjoyed Tokyo Ghoul, but I'm enjoying this series, like, this, you know, this new sequel more and more by the chapters, because this chapter was pretty damn good. Like, I think it's because, like, each chapter we reveal or we get more things that we want to be answered more and more throughout or whatever, like, or slightly hinted at something or whatever. But it's just, like, because there's so many questions or things left unanswered because of the prior series, Tokyo Ghoul, and Tokyo Ghoul Ray should be answering. And if they are, or they're, you know, like, being vague about the details, but they're giving us something at the very least. And I'm happy about that because... Man, this was a good-ass chapter. We're getting further and further into the confrontation with Torso, and also we're learning more and more about the events that happen and things with characters like themselves. Like, can I say at this point, I am really like I really hate Urie. I don't exactly hate him. Like, how do I express this? Like, I think he is the biggest dick in the fucking room. Like, he is the guy that's gonna mess everyone up because he's a selfish, self-centered son of a bitch who only cares about himself from the looks of it, from what he didn't show in case and introduce. And I was right about Shirasu with my previous review, where I said he seemed like he respected Sasaki and, you know, was, you know, like, he was loyal and all that. But, you know, he was, like, that, like, rogue, like, badass-ish. Like, honestly, like, the character, Shirasu, reminds me so much of Kuobara from Yu Yu Hakusho. I'm like, oh, that's fucking Kuobara right there. Only a little bit more vicious and whatever. And, and he can actually, you know, have to deal some game. Like, because, like, Kuobara, you know, as the series went on, he got a little bit, you know, sheepier and weaker and all that. It just became a joke at that point, but. I'm pretty sure that's not going to be the same case with Shirasu. It's just, like, a simple fact that the character kind of resembles, like, how he acts and how his intellect a little bit as a prior character to the series that I love quite fondly. I'm just pointing that simple fact out, that's all. But, yeah, Shirasu and all that, but, let me start from the beginning. We have the little girl from last chapter that apparently was 24, and she is 24 at this point, but she just looks like a little loli. But yeah, we have that little girl that Shie, the girl's name. She is a photographer who obviously, you know, just who's investigating the Torso case or just looking up info. She finds. You know, she finds stuff in here and there because there's always a buyer around who's willing to pay good money for whatever she has on the table. And, and she knows these guys are chasing after Torso case. She's like, I'm going to take on this opportunity and just, like, you know, get something that I need from them or that I want from them for somebody else. So, and I give them what they need. So I like that aspect of it. Like, it was, a trade, an equal, like, thing. Like, you have something I want, I have something you want, like, you know, like, whatever. Like, she just wants to make her friend happy that apparently wants clothes from Sasaki. Wants Sasaki's clothes, anything that has a scent off that of him. Because, this person that apparently... We got showcased Shie, like, in the first, like, she has some ties with Tsukiyama. Or as relative of Tsukiyama. And, I also don't understand. I don't know if it's translation error or not. But it was said that the person that wanted the belongings, Shie alluded to it being a female, not a male. So I'm confused in that aspect of it. But, you know, you never know or whatever. Like, I don't know, Shu could have gotten a sex change over the past 3 years. I don't fucking know. I'm just saying. But, like, serious business. I think it might have been just a translation error. If not, like, it could be an interesting other thing to, you know, come across in the future. And whatever. But, yeah. You know, basically, it's alluding more to the fact of, like, obviously, Sasaki is Kaneki, which I like this chapter a lot because it did that, like, many times. Like, it showcased, like, a lot of things, little subtle hints that said that Sasaki at this point is actually Kaneki, which at this point, I'm going to rest my case saying that he's not somebody else. Like, he's definitely Kaneki. Like, I'm going to admit to it. I'm just, like, anyone out there who was, like, bitching or not bitching, like, just arguing the fact that maybe I was wrong. Like, I admit to the fact that I was wrong. I was just keeping an open mind. I'm just saying. But like at this point, like, I'm like, yeah, it's fucking Kaneki. Ekareki! Cabrón, you know, like, it's freaking Kaneki, you know? Like, anyone would yell out and say that, like, you know, it's dead obvious. Like, I know it's dead obvious, but I just try to keep an open mind as to maybe it's somebody else. But this chapter, just like I said, very elusively or just subtly hinted at the fact that him, he's Kaneki. Like, I can't deny these facts anymore. Like, that's definitely him. Like, there's nothing I can say. It's just like, you're like, I buy this shit super quick, but like I can't keep my open mind anymore. I can still keep it open, but I think I'm more definitely just definitively leaning toward the fact that that's Sasaki. I mean, Sasaki is connected at this point, just with his memories all erased or something, and he's being haunted by his old self in these nightmares, which I wonder how frequently he's been getting them. Like he said, he's gotten them like quite a lot of times, and is it by what time are his nightmares gonna fucking just finally get to him and finally showcase, or just like get his memories back or something like that, you know? Like, I mean, his dreams just want him to know who he really is, or just like, you know. But yeah, with the information thing, we have Urie tricking Shirasu because Shirasu is a gullible idiot, but you know, you love the character anyways, because Urie is a some bitch dick. But I'm pretty sure, like, these characters, like, even we were briefly alluded a little bit also to the backstories of these characters, or to be more specific, we were briefly alluded to the fact that Shirasu has more to his past. Like, we find out that he actually took upon the surgery to become a half ghoul to get some funds. He needed money for some reason, and even up to today, he still needs money for something. But I'm guessing to the fact that he probably could be some kind of sick family member or something like that that he deeply cares about, and that's why he needs the money like very severely. And I like that's what I'm assuming. Like you can tell like these characters are somewhat relatable, and I think even Urie to a point. Like not everyone, you know, becomes a dick or is a dick immediately. There's definitely gonna be something in his past that made him turn to how he is nowadays. But as he's still gonna be a dick for a long time, and I definitely think that we're gonna get to showcase all these characters' backstories, all the new one-eyed ghouls that we just got introduced to. We're all gonna, you know, learn why they're this way, like right now. Not immediately, but like it's gonna be slow and whatever. And like, I'm pretty sure they're all justified for why they took up on that surgery to become a half ghoul. The reasoning for it, and like, you know, and we're gonna get to be more in touch with these characters. Because Shuei Ishida doesn't just write a freaking tragedy, he writes dramas, because this thing, like, Tokyo Ghoul definitely is a drama through and through, no matter what you say. It's a drama and a tragedy and many other things, and it's a glorious series. And I applaud Shuei Ishida because he writes this, like, so amazing and just so driven and rich storytelling. But yeah, getting back to the chapter, because this is going to run for a while, I'm pretty sure. My nose. But yeah, but we have that bit, and we have now Shirasu having some lack of trust with Sasaki because, you know, Urie, you know, like lied to him or just like tricked him a little bit in here and there. And then we still have them investigating Torso case solo, and then now we have Sasaki because he can't keep them controlled on under a leash. He has to take upon him the role of finishing this case so they don't fuck up and they don't cause problems for him, or they don't get injured in any means in any way while pursuing this case. You know, he's look he's he goes he I need to be sasa serious now. He's like, it's kind of funny and all that. Like, this is a very comedic chapter. Just I want to point it out too. It's a very comedic chapter, which I think I really enjoyed more because of that, but also because they delved in more things, you know, they haven't delved in just yet. Yeah, we have that. We have him going to the prison, to the ghoul prison that, you know, they have and all that. Real quick, I want to point out the fact that didn't they mention the last series, and you know, like in the Tokyo Ghoul series in chapter 143, that they exterminated every single ghoul that was in the prison? I'm questioning that right now. Like they said so last, you know, like last series, and now this series the prison's still there, and or at least they have one of the prisoners. Maybe they'll explain it later. I'm not certain right now, but still, like, we see father there. You know, Amon's, Catholic father that he had and all that. He gives info because he's kept there because he gives good insight on, you know, what ghouls are thinking and everything. He's like, He's like the Hannibal Lecter. He's like, you know, of the ghoul Tokyo Ghoul world, which I kind of like a lot. Like, that was cool. It would make sense that you would keep a character like that around, because it makes for great, you know, like rich like scenes to play out, and like good dialogue, and it just like it's good. Like, he even had like a moment with Mitsuki, where he was fucking, you know, he was playing with him, just like saying, "You look yummy and delicious. Oh god, that innocence in you, like." That straight up was like some Hannibal Lecter shit. I was like, okay, back away, back away. I like that Sasaki stepped in, and it was like, even though he was like half dead asleep, he was like, just like, fuck, just stop teasing with the boy. Like, come on, come on. Like, just, I came here for you, man. Just fine. He gives good intel on, you know, he on the to help out with the investigation of finding torso and all that, or like just figuring out who the guy is and just stopping all that. He tells Sasaki that basically he's a cab driver. He's somebody who's fearful of humans, but he's also integrated himself into human society very well. And like, you know, like, yeah, you know, you just find you need to find somebody with that kind of profile, and that also is a taxi driver. And you know, we leave that scene. We have after that we have what do we have after that like oh yeah we have we he We have the nightmare that ensues on inside Sasaki's head that has like that alludes to a white-haired Kaneki, like his inner, you know, self in, you know, in his head, like whatever, and like, you know, like this like darkly shaded figure with only white hair. It's like, ah, come on, like now you're just giving it to me straight up in a plate. Like, at this point, I don't even need to be like, I'll keep an open mind, like I just said. I'm like, yeah, that's him. Like, I'm shutting up now. I rest my case. And done. And done. But yeah, we have that little nightmare thing in the show. Like, you know, he gets him frequently. You know, it's like a little ghost in his head in a sense. You know, like of his past. You know, because he forgot who he was. He was tricked into, you know, being brainwashed or whatever to being who he thinks he is. But yeah, we have that scene. We have him going further. You know, with the investigation and all that. What else do we have? Oh, man, I'm trying to recall. Like, after that, what other scenes we have? Like, I remember the end, but I don't remember. Oh yeah, fudge, 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 fudge. Okay, I can't recall what else happened. If I missed something, just point it out in the comics, like in the comments. I like, just call me out, like I forgot this or whatever. But yeah, last thing we have, like that I recall, is somebody stepping into the cab and the torso, and then I think it was Hinami because it looks like her character design, but she was a little darkly shaded that you couldn't quite tell. But I think it's definitely Hinami. Not to mention, she seems to have, we know that she has affiliations with Ayato, and Ayato has affiliations with Aokiri-3, so at this point, she possibly is a member of Aokiri-3 or so, you know, just working for Ayato. And yeah, you know, that she's coming in saying, like, I have a message for you, or a mission for you, if I don't call one or two, from the tree torso, you know, and that's where the chapter ends. And it's like, we're supposed to guess who this person is, like, but it kind of looks like Hinami, definitely. But yeah, this was a good chapter. It wasn't all that amazing, but I found it more enjoyable than the last two chapters that came out. I might not score it as high, but I will say, because I scored them together, you know, like the last chapters. I scored them at 9, I think, once, something like that. Yeah, but I'm gonna score this one a 7 because it was a good chapter. It progressed a few things that we needed progressing on. It also alluded to a few facts, that, you know, a few things that we want answered because we have so many questions about it. But yeah, I enjoyed it quite fondly. I hope you enjoyed this review. I'll keep making more reviews because I love this series. So yeah, if you want to watch more of me, you're going to watch more of me. I'll try and keep it short as I can, but right now I guess I ran a little bit too much. But yeah, I think with that said, I'll see you soon. Hopefully with something new. Yay!